Hey guys, Disney Dante here. I decided to do something different today. I decided to try and use my sister's laptop to do a review. A, for better lighting, B, for better quality, and C, for so you can actually see the dolls without me shaking the camera so much. The review's gonna have to be cut short because I just did an entire review. It was about 10 minutes or so long, and it cut off at 7 minutes. So you didn't even get to see these little guys. So I'm gonna try and keep it under 7 minutes if I can. If I can't, well, I'm just gonna have to try again. Okay, so it comes with formal Merida, Queen Eleanor, Adventure Merida, and the three wee devils, or the triplets. Okay, let's start with formal Merida. Now, her face, you can see it, I don't know if you can see it, there you go. It's the same as the 12-inch one. It's got little freckles, tad bit of blush, each little stroke of the eyebrow looks like it's done by hand, which I'm sure it's not, but it looks like it is. Their arms and legs are movable, but they're not posable like the 12-inch ones. They're just like the standard Barbie, you know, arms. But her knees do bend at one point here. They've been their one point joint, I guess. She has blue flats held in by rubber bands. I don't recommend taking them out because if they do, they'll just fall off. She's got a little belt, a little glitter belt. It's sewn in about right here, but not recommend cutting off that sewing part because it's just gonna leave a big hole and there's no reason to cut it. She's got a glitter. Not glitter. She's got a gold trim around the bottom of her dress, just like in the movie and the 12-inch doll. It's made out of a different material than the one in 12-inch, but I think it's very fitting. It goes away all the way around the back, which I like because you know it makes it look not cheap. Also, her belt goes all the way around the back, and she's velcroed in the back, so there she is. I'm holding her by her hair. It's kind of scary, but it's a very nice doll. The fabric is soft, just like the 12-inch. Her hair. Only complaint about her hair, she's got this big wad of nap in the back, but that's just the way she was packaged. I've seen on other people's pictures. This Merida has that same problem, but it's not as bad, and everybody's, not just mine. This one, it's just the way she was packaged. She had a large chunk of her hair under a piece of plastic like that. But, it's doable, it works, because it's Merida, so I just deal with it. And when I display her, I have her like this, not like this, so you can't really tell. The curls are just as soft and bouncy as the 12-inch one. They're fun to just, you know, I guess, kind of hold. I like its teeth, I don't know why. But, yes, so that's the formal Merida here. It's great quality. I love this doll. Now, I think they're around 6 inches. I'm not exactly sure. I haven't looked, but I think they're around 6 inches. Maybe five, four and a half, maybe. I don't know. Anyways, they're not the 12-inch ones, obviously. Here's Queen Eleanor. Her face is like that. Her face is not exactly like the 12-inch one, but it's still beautiful. She's got a crown held in by little plastic key ties. Crown looks just like the 12-inch one. She's got these gold little ribbon things in her hair, in her braids. Just it looks, you know, just like the movie. She has these big sleeves with a glitter trim around it, which I thought was a nice detail. It must be hard to get a little trim on that. She does not have a plastic belt like the 12-inch one or the movie has. That's my only if. I mean, I don't mind that much actually, but yeah, she does not have a belt, so disclaimer. And there's the back. Her hair can go, you know, in front or behind. I like to keep this one in front because it came like that, so it's kind of curvy. So I just like to keep it. She comes with dark green flats right there, and her knees also bend. So yeah, that's Queen Eleanor. Fabric's very soft, of course. I actually like this one. I don't know which doll's my favorite, but she may be. I don't know. So that's her. Her hair is very soft. I would not recommend taking it out. I don't see why you would want to, but so yeah, that's her. Sorry I'm rushing again. I know I am. It's just I don't want it to cut off on me again. Okay, here's Games Merida. Normally I'd do much more detail, but okay. Here's Games Merida. She may be my favorite, actually. She's got a cape, which is like a faux fur cape. It's actually made out of, not the material the 12-inch one is, it's like the material the plush is made out of, if you have that one. I'll be reviewing her later, but it's like a faux fur type thing. She's got her green dress on, that she wears in the movie. Oh, sorry, and in all the promos. She's got, actually, Sorry. Oh, sorry. Anyway, she's got brown flats. Sorry, I'm not used to this camera. She's got brown flats held in by rubber bands. She's got, I found out what it's called. This gold stuff is called organza. I found that out. So she's got organza sleeves. And it's not like in the 12-inch doll where it goes green sleeve, and the more organza, it just goes green sleeve, organza, and it cuts off at the elbow, but I don't mind. It still looks great. This doll comes with a little, leather armband, just like the 12-inch one. I thought that was a great detail. It even has a gold little lacy thing, or trim right there, which I thought was perfect. So I love that little detail, because the regular princess dolls don't come with gloves or anything, as she did. She's Merida, she's awesome. Face is just like the formal Merida, just like the 12-inch. Hair, like I said, does not have as bad of a problem with naps, because it's just the way they were packaged differently. So that's her. I love her hair. It's very, bouncy, soft. She's got a great detail. Actually, the 12-inch Merida's bow would work with her, I guess. It'd just be kind of big. But, so that's Merida. Our Adventure Merida. And last but not least, are the Triplet Brothers. They're plastic. They're not made of doll. They don't have any doll hair on them or anything. That's them. They got very great detail. Everything looks like it's hand-painted, which maybe, I don't know. Got the little plaid on their kilts. Here's the back. Looks very detailed, very cute. I like how they're all separate. So you can display them differently in pictures. I like to take pictures of my stuff, so that's them. Retails for $24.50 because obviously it comes with 6 dolls instead of the normal 4. And I think it's more detailed than the regular Princess mini doll set. So it's coming up on 7 minutes. So if it cuts off here, then bye guys.